Hi, everybody. It's Leslie with the New Mexico Small Business Development Center. And I'm here today with Dr. Marvin Lozano and Dr. Michaela Rivera, who are going to be presenting a bilingual session in English and Spanish on transitioning to the new normal. It is going to be very interesting. And if you have any questions, please type them into the Q&A so we can answer your questions throughout the webinar. The New Mexico Small Business Development Center wants to encourage all New Mexico small businesses to be aware of the threats to their cybersecurity. We have webinars available pre-recorded on demand, and we strongly encourage you to take advantage of our webinar series and protect your business against ransomware. With all that, I'm going to turn it over to Dr. Rivera.
Good morning. Good morning, Leslie. Thank you for having us this morning. We're very excited to be continuing the series with the SBDC and all the good work that you do. Buenos días a todos. Me llamo Michaela Rivera. Yo soy psicóloga y trabajo con adultos ahorita en la comunidad. Vivo aquí en Albuquerque, pero por donde quiera puedo trabajar con la gente por internet. No hay problema con eso ahorita, con el salud mental. Conmigo esta mañana es el doctor Marvin Lozano. Doctor Lozano.
Sí, buenos días. Buenos días y bienvenidos a todos. Yo me llamo Marvin Lozano. El doctorado que tengo yo es en educación, pero estudié muchos, también en negocios. En Arizona tengo una maestría también y estamos aquí para ayudar con poca información acerca de COVID-19 y cómo seguimos tratando todos a quedar bien, ¿no? Y de eso vamos a tratar esta mañana.
Ok, vamos a hablar sobre la asistencia que se ofrece el SBDC. Pienso que la señora Leslie va a hacer eso también. Pero aquí queremos ofrecer información cómo pueden los emprendedores hacer cosas para avanzar la salud física y mentalmente, la sanidad durante y después del COVID. La cosa que tenemos que recordar es que aunque la gente dice que ya se pasó el COVID, no ha pasado, todavía sigue. We're going to be offering information about steps you can take to continue to deal with COVID. Even though people are saying COVID is over, COVID is not over. The variants, which are more contagious and more deadly or dangerous, continue among adults who are not vaccinated and young children. So we still need to talk about keeping folks in our business and who come to us for business safe as well.
And I'll do this part in English. Previously, I did it in Spanish, so it's a bilingual type workshop. I just wanted to add to what Dr. Rivera is saying here, because this is the slide, if you will, where we talk about vision and an overview. I subscribe to Time Magazine, and I wanted to share with you that in the recent, I don't know if you see this, I think you can see it now. There's a picture in the copy that was most recently done with an individual wearing a mask. And the message they're trying to convey is that this is the new world that we're going to be working in business, in factories, in industry. So many folks don't like that. They're resentful, whether they're employees or whether they're clients. And so it behooves us as small business people to develop skills to be mentally able to deal with folks that may be difficult with that idea. And Dr. Rivera is very skilled in doing that. She'll be talking about that. The other thing I want to share with you, as I do in all our workshops, is that I do every day take a look at the Wall Street Journal because it focuses in our state what's happening. And there are articles on that COVID, people continue to die from COVID. There continue to be infections. I believe yesterday there were 203 infections in the state. So we all need to work together to prevent this and to keep a grasp of it as we go forward.
Next slide. We encourage you to visit the New Mexico Small Business Development website to see the large offerings, the large number of offerings that are for you at no charge. Simply, all you have to do is register to. Se ofrece el SBDC muchos entrenamientos por el internet. Si vas a esa dirección en el internet al nmsbdc.org, puedes encontrar la lista y firmar para asistir gratis a esos.
Y si tienen amigos o vamos a decir otros conocidos en negocios que manejan o son dueños, por favor díganle de los de los ofrecimientos que tenemos aquí, las ofertas, porque les no tienen que pagar. El Estado, el federal, está pagando por esto y les conviene participar. Es cuando pueden hacer preguntas en español o en inglés, como quieran. So I'm just saying that those of you that speak Spanish or those of you that speak English, let others know in your community about the SBDC and the offerings and these webinars. They're for you. They're to improve your ability to be successful.
Next slide.
I'll do this in English and then in Spanish. This is primarily a workshop on the mental aspects that Dr. Rivera is trained to share with you. But my role here then is to provide some educational type focus. And I do that in the first bullet, because I think it's important for all of us small business owners. I work throughout the state as a consultant. And when I work with small businesses, that's my area. It has been for the past 30 years, in one way or the other, education or as a lender or in as a consultant. And that's, we want to keep you safe and healthy, okay? So I'll be talking about some of the steps you can continue to take, Dr. Rivera.
What I will be doing is, after Dr. Lozano talks about steps to remaining healthy and safe physically, I will be talking about the sources of stress that we've all been through to recognize it, so that we can recognize it in the future as we go forward, okay? And what are some key steps to managing change, crisis and change? We are going to a new normal, is what they're calling it. Normal does not always mean healthy. Normal means most people. And so we really need to keep our eye on health. Después de que el doctor Lozano comparte esa información sobre la salud física, yo voy a hablar sobre el estrés, las fuentes del estrés y la pérdida y dolor de COVID, no solamente para hablar de lo que pasó, sino para hablar de lo que podemos reconocer en el, porque hablan del nuevo normal, pero normal no siempre debe decir que es salud. Saludable, sino es la mayoría de la gente. Así. Tenemos que dar el foco en la salud.
Okay. Next. Okay, so I'll do this in Spanish, and then, or rather, we're still doing the outline, but I will do it in Spanish and in English. And again, the idea is here, as you see, Roman numeral one, it's steps that you and your business can take to keep your business safe and healthy. Es lo que pueden ustedes, los pasos que tomen para tengan su negocio, que tengan buena salud y que sigan con sus objetivos de tener buen éxito en su negocio.
Good, next slide.
Entonces, en español y luego en inglés. I'll be doing this in Spanish and English. Medidas que pueden tomar ustedes son cuatro aquí de las que hablo. Primero, es muy claro. sigue la idea de la máscara, ¿no? Como les dije en el nacionalmente en el magazine Time, muy popular, tienen un foto de un señor, vamos a decir una máquina que parece un señor con una máscara, y el dicho que tienen abajo es nunca vamos a seguir igual. Okay, entonces hay que acordarse de eso, que les ayuda la máscara, y eso va a seguir en una forma u otra. Como emprendedores, gente de negocio, hay que tener que manejar la límite. Si tienen un edificio donde tienen su negocio, que no entren totalmente toda la gente que quiere entrar a su negocio alguna vez, ¿no? Que entren y unos depende, ¿no? En qué tipo de negocio que tienen, de seguro. Por ejemplo, sabemos que en el periódico del día de hoy, en el norte de Nuevo México, donde están los Navajos, ellos ya abrieron también para tener negocio. Viene mucho turista para comprarle a los negocios que tienen ellos. Y lo que dicen ellos es, sí, queremos abrir, queremos tener negocio, pero vamos a limitar la gente que puede entrar una vez. ¿Okay? Usted también tiene que pensar eso. Y también yo, como entro a muchos negocios, y me imagino que ustedes también, practiquen tener los que 6 pies aparte de otra persona. La máscara y los 6 pies. Si no la máscara, a lo mínimo, 6 pies distancia, ¿no? Siguiendo esa práctica es bueno. Y también cuando van pasando otra gente que viene del otro parte del edificio, ¿no? Con buen pensamiento, que ¿okay? No se enojen, pase un por un lado y la otra persona por otro lado, pero que se den distancia, ¿ok? So what I was saying was that this idea is not going to go away of wearing masks. The Time magazine article in the most recent issue has a picture of what it looks to be like a figure of a male worker, or it could be female worker, in a factory wearing a mask. The message you're conveying is that this is the new norm. It says, we will never be the same. That's the heading. And so with that, I ask you to please wear a face covering, especially if you aren't vaccinated. And you may be around people that are not vaccinated, and you're not vaccinated, so that'll continue contributing to sick people in your surroundings and in our community. Also limit your store occupancy. I was saying that in today's paper, in today's Albuquerque Journal, up north, there's an article of the Navajo Nation has opened up also huge area for tourism. They have many businesses, and they are also limiting store occupancy. So, you know, it's something that we can all unify to do, okay? Practice physical distancing and implement one-way aisles, other things you can do. Next. Bueno, también hay que tener nota que si pueden tener preventivos, inventario de preventivos en su tienda, es buena idea tenerlos, ¿no? O en su placer de negocio, en su localizan, porque así pueden tenerlos para ustedes y para sus empleados y para los clientes. Y también los pueden vender si quieren. Y luego también limpien la tienda, si tienen tienda, que esté todo limpio, ¿no? Para que no haya peligro. Que todos se tengan un físico para ver si están bien, y también que se laven las manos. Es algo bueno para practicar. So I was saying here just briefly, 4 things to we can all practice is keep supplies on hand for those folks that need to use sanitizer. You may even want to sell them, okay? But at least keep supplies on hand. Good practice for a business. You know, clean. Make sure after you have large traffic, clean in places. We have variants of COVID out in the community now that are difficult to control, especially folks that are not vaccinated. And so I'm seeing this as folks enter stores. Some wear masks, some don't. Many more are not wearing masks than are. So, you know, practice this to protect yourself and others. And conduct wellness checks before work of your employees. And wash your hands and have them wash your hands. All these things are very manageable. We can do them, right?
Well, I just had a question. What type of measures can someone take? ¿Qué puede hacer el dueño para chequear si el trabajador está saludable? Entonces, por ejemplo, tiene calentura. ¿Qué puede hacer?
That's an excellent question. Lo que pregunta la doctora es qué puede hacer la persona de negocio para prevenir antes que entren no a su negocio, empleados, vamos a ser clientes también. And so I just wanted to clarify in Spanish for those Spanish speakers what the question was. I'll say it in Spanish, in English, and then in Spanish. That the idea is I've been fortunate in my work career. And that I've also managed groups of people. And what I always thought was important was to have meetings in the morning. It doesn't have to be long. Have a 5-10 minute meeting with your employees and remind them. They have other lives outside the workplace and they get preoccupied. So spend 5 or 10 minutes. It doesn't have to be long, but just remind everybody that you're a team. And as a team, you want to keep everybody healthy. So you can all have jobs and keep going forward.
Okay. Entonces, por ejemplo, one of the things is if the store opens at 8 or the business opens at 8:30, the employee has to be there ready to work at 8:15. Because sometimes the employees will walk in with the customers. Okay. So those are the types of things that people
can. Right. And so and you can do things that are creative, right? You're the leader here, you know, bring coffee. Bring orange juice, if they're orange juice drinkers, bring some donuts, or if they're Spanish speakers and you know, culturally you want to be real sensitive, bring empanadas. You know, it's a pastry that is culturally appropriate for many folks in the state. And so, right? So what we want to do is we want to make it welcoming. You want folks to want to come to work, not to look at it as something that they wait till the last minute to come in.
Exactly. So if you have questions, you can write them in the queue today and we address those, or if you have other new ways of doing. One of the things that I've seen some businesses do is that, for example, if the customer does a certain action, then they get their name put into a drawing, like not a raffle because you don't pay for it, but a drawing so that they can win a prize.
Good idea.
So that the business owner can have the hand sanitizer there.
Right.
And so every time that the person finishes checking out and cleans their hands with hand sanitizer, they put in a copy of the receipt with a person's name into the drawing.
Sure.
Okay. So una cosa que puede hacer un dueño es cuando se lava las manos con el sanitizer. Okay. Con los químicos, no con el agua, sino después de pagar por la mercancía, entonces pueden poner el nombre en una caja para que escogen raffle para ganar un premio una vez a la semana.
O tarjetas también, si traen una tarjeta de negocio, que saquen la tarjeta de negocio. Así usted también puede saber quién le está comprando inventario y pueden saber nota de quién es la persona, ¿no? ¿Y qué es el más bonito nombre en el mundo? El nombre de usted. Igual como el nombre cuando oye usted su nombre, ¿no? Entonces se pone todo, pues sí, es mi nombre, ¿no? Así son los clientes y los empleados.
¿Cómo no? Eso es una cosa diferente que pueden hacer, pero así pueden crecer y desarrollar al negocio y quedarse sano también.
So just briefly in English, we were saying we got carried away there a little bit, but there are many things that you can do. Just be innovative and creative. And I think what is true still to this day is that the most beautiful word in the English language is your name. So use that in a positive way with your workers, you know, recognize them by name. Train them to recognize your customers by name. And you know, it just creates for a positive environment. So when you're dealing with difficult things, you ease into dealing with that difficult situation where you may need to talk to someone about, hey, you know, please keep 6 feet away, or please don't get difficult. We're doing this for your health, right, Dr. Rivera?
Exactly. So it's simple things that we're already have been doing, but we want to continue doing it. Okay. Next slide. I'm going to talk about the stressors very briefly that we went through when COVID was active, because we're going to go through some of these again, I think. Voy a hablar de los factores estresantes en los negocios durante la pandemia. Y eso fue, por ejemplo, cambiando las regulaciones y cómo hacen el negocio, por ejemplo. Y cuando hablo del negocio también, tenemos familias y escuelas son un negocio. Aunque no estamos dando el foco exclusivamente, las escuelas son negocios también. Entonces ya cambiaron las reglas una vez para el COVID en las escuelas. Cada comunidad tiene que decidir qué vamos a hacer en el otoño cuando regresan los niños a la escuela. Every community has to think for themselves and decide how are we going to do things in our community when the children go back to school. Children meaning from age, now it's from age 3, pre-K, all the way, or 4, all the way through high school, through the end of high school, and for some, the community colleges and universities. So every community has to decide what are the rules going to be. And one of the stressors is if people get confused or they don't want to follow. Okay, so one of the things, una cosa que es difícil es cuando se cambian las reglas dentro de la comunidad y algunos cumplen con las reglas y otros no, y algunos sí, otros no. Se confunden la gente, se ponen frustrados y luego no quieren hacerlo. Ni voy a hacerlo. Pero la enfermedad no sabe eso. La enfermedad se va a ir una persona a otra persona, especialmente dentro de la gente que no tiene la vacuna. So people can tell, I'm following the rules, I'm not going to follow the rules, they are, they aren't, etc. They get confused, they get frustrated, they get angry and say, forget it, I'm not going to do this. But the variants, and the main variant that we have in country so far is Delta. And it's called the Delta variant. It's the COVID has changed into this Delta. So it's a family member of it, but more dangerous than COVID-19. And it's being spread especially among people who don't have the vaccine. So one of the things that they're saying is it is not too late to get the vaccine. And I know Dr. Lozano has already spoken about it, but it's not too late to get the vaccine. And eventually they'll be talking about vaccines for younger people. I think now it goes down perhaps to age 14. Don't quote me on that. But they will be looking at it for younger children. And it's really important because we love our children and we want them to have better lives than we have. That's why we work so hard, so that our children have better lives. So un método de hacer la vida mejor para nuestros hijos es vivir sano y usando los pasos preventivos.
Dr. Rivera, I have a question. Tengo una pregunta a la doctora, ¿no? Since we're talking about stressors in business during the pandemic, and of course, one of the things we all know is many, many, many times, right, withdrawal in your businesses are balancing family and children, as Dr. Rivera is saying, and we don't know what the future holds in terms of policy and regulations in the school system. But what I want to ask Dr. Rivera is, what would be one good technique to handle a difficult parent or a difficult business person or a difficult customer that doesn't like a new regulation that's put in place? We don't have the time to get into all the different techniques, but what may be a way for someone that's all of a sudden find themselves in the middle of a very upset parent or an upset employee. La pregunta es entonces a la doctora es un ejemplo de cómo manejar una persona que se pone muy difícil, aunque sea otro padre o alguien de negocio o un empleado, ¿no? Dr. Rivera.
Okay, la cosa con cada persona en el mundo, no importa la edad, pues los infantes, pero los niños hacia los ancianos. One thing that is true among all people from young children, I'm not talking in, okay, but I'm talking young children through the elderly. People want to have a choice. Okay? And la cosa que pasó con esta enfermedad y los cubiertos, las máscaras, fue que ustedes tienen que usar estas máscaras. Y contestaron, pues tú no me puedes hacer eso. Yo tengo mis derechos. A lot of people instead responded, well, you can't make me wear a mask. When this first started, the people said, you have to wear a mask. Well, they can't make me wear a mask. They can't make me get a shot. You're right. Right. We can't. And yes, people do have their rights. That's what people come to this country for. And those who are born here treasure and maintain that.
Yes.
But if you're a business owner and you want to stay healthy for current customers and for future customers, and you want children to be safe, say, okay, I recognize that. Here we believe in the use of those, and you do have a choice. You can either comply with our rules, or we can meet you outside and deliver what's outside. Okay?
A choice.
Pueden escoger. La gente pueden escoger. Si no quieres usar la máscara, no quieres llevarse como las reglas dicen, entonces está bien. Puedes escoger. Puedes ir siguiendo las reglas, o si no quieres, puedes salir de la tienda o de la oficina y podemos tener o llevar tus compras afuera para usted. Porque aquí adentro vamos a seguir siguiendo esas reglas.
Okay.
So they have a choice. They don't like it, you don't need to fight with them about it. Because that doesn't do anything except make problems.
It escalates things.
It makes things worse, yes.
Right.
Okay. And then I see into la política y todo eso.
Okay.
One of the things, can you put it back? There you go. Thanks. One of the things also that was that there was a loss of fines. And notice now, this last weekend, they said, oh, well, everything's open now. Everything's open. It was July 1. It's open. Okay. Well, I think everybody was on the street, driving up and down the street, because it was something this weekend. And
people wanted to get out.
Well, we purposely did not want to get out because everybody else was getting out. But, right. I mean, there were traffic jams in town, people trying to get out. And so one of the things that people noticed, you know, estoy diciendo que todo se abrió el primer día de julio por aquí en Nuevo México. Pero ahí salieron toda la gente a los caminos y ya estaban manejando y todo. Y fue muy difícil allá afuera. Mejor quedarte en la casa otra semana. Pero lo que estoy diciendo es que ya en salir y ver, puedes ver que algunos negocios no se existen.
Mm.
Okay, there are some businesses that we go to in the community that no longer exist.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Okay, and or they're very, very limited. Restaurants have had to really, because they've had problems getting the food supplies and getting the customers, they have a very small menu and they're very limited on what they can offer. So those are things that frustrate people and they think, oh my gosh, you know, this can't be and all this. Well, people have to work back in to what they are able to do.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, durante la pandemia, perdieron clientes y empleados. Y ya en salir, a ver otra vez, ya está abierto todo por el primer día de julio. Ya llegando a algún lugar, en algunos lugares, ya no existen los negocios. No sobrevivieron. Okay, they could not survive it. O, por ejemplo, los restaurantes tienen que tener el menú más chiquito, que no se pueden ofrecer tanto, porque al principio no tienen la gente viniendo a comer. Y dos, es más difícil conseguir los ingredientes para un menú muy grande y no quieren perder la comida si no van a servirlo. Y también han subido los precios.
Entonces,
so everything has gotten more expensive. and the food may be different or not, you know, they may not be making your very favorite whatever, but that's because they either can't get the ingredients or it's just not feasible to do it for a while.
Entonces, I'll ask this in English and then we'll transition to Spanish, I think. But the question that comes to mind for me is because I imagine many of our viewers are currently in business. Those are the ones that have been successfully able to survive and navigate the pandemic. So, and they may be experiencing stress and thinking, I may be next, right? They may be next, you know, am I going to be closing my doors next? Because one of the points on this slide is decreased revenue, right? And so it's something everybody struggles with is how do I maintain that revenue in my business to pay my employees, to keep my doors open and keep working, right?
Yes.
And so I imagine that's a stress. Le está diciendo, preguntando a la doctora que aparte ustedes que están presentes porque quieren seguir con éxito. No, no, es que ustedes ya saben que bueno, para seguir adelante tienen que protegerse y hay estrés en eso también. ¿Es cierto, no?
No, no, es muy difícil porque con ese estrés, de vez en cuando, si la gente no tiene confianza, tienen miedo. Okay. Often when people don't have trust, they have fear. And so they need to be sure, well, am I going to be able to make it or not? There's something that I want to talk about that may go with the slides later and maybe a little bit different that we've not shared before. And that is one of the things that this country has built itself on is competition.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the United States has built itself on competition and being good, and they still compete. That's why people love the Olympics.
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh, we're going to be the best, you know, we're going to run and jump and be the best, et cetera. This country values and promotes competition. However, with the pandemic, to survive with the new normal, it may be a good idea to begin cooperating with similar businesses.
Mm-hmm.
You have to decide that as a business owner. I cannot decide that. But it may be that in cooperation with another company that does roofing, you can cooperate with another roofing company where one company does repairs, one does all new roofs.
Mm-hmm.
And I know that business-wise and money-wise, there's a difference with how much is earned, but those are the types of things that people share equipment, they share goods, they share customers. So you need to know where you go, who is now doing this versus that.
Una idea muy importante. This is a really important idea. I want to make sure I emphasize it in Spanish. Okay, so bear with me here. I'll do it in Spanish so the folks are clear on it. La idea entonces es muy importante, doctora Lacuevo. Yo es que la idea es que ustedes, como son emprendedores, un emprendedor piensa afuera de la caja. Piensa de qué idea es nueva que me puede ayudar a seguir y tener buen éxito. En eso es cómo puedo trabajar con otros en como equipo. Y es muy importante porque lo que tenemos puesto en la mente es cómo podemos competir con otra persona, ¿no? Pero aquí lo que para ganar, yo voy a ganar, yo voy a ser mejor. Aquí la cosa es cómo puedo trabajar con otra gente, con otro negocio, y así todos ganamos, cooperamos, ¿no? Y seguimos adelante. Ok.
Y eso es más fácil, así debe ser también en la familia. Cuando se entra en competición en una familia, casi siempre hay problemas. Cuando pueden cooperar, entonces salen mejor, especialmente en la familia.
Muy bien.
When there's competition in a family and in a marriage, usually that doesn't turn out very well, but cooperating works a lot better. Pero tienen que pensar diferente, como dice el doctor Lozano. You have to think very differently because people don't think like that. They'll say, well, I always came in your business. Well, I always came here for this. Yes, yes. And I am working with them and they are carrying that for you. So when you need something else, this is what we're carrying. And part of it is the answer to this chronic problem about the supply chain. And I don't know if you want to address the issue of, you know, getting, in the case of restaurants, of course, it's the food, which has been a big battle. Supplies. I mean, the supplies to remodel homes and do other things. So anyway, la cosa de cooperar en vez de competir, deberían pensar en eso porque pueden resolver un problema con cooperación y todos pueden ganar. Okay, now. Sabemos cómo va a ser. Pensamos que sabemos, pero no sabemos. De veras. No sabemos cómo va a ser en el otoño. We don't know what the future will bring. We kind of know and we're hoping for it and we're planning for it, but we know that they are saying the fall will be worse because the unvaccinated and the variants are still out there. Okay, and so we don't know where it will hit or how it will hit or how quickly. So the healthcare providers, you know, they're saying, come in for your dental checks and come in for your screenings and come in for the surgery you put off, etc. But they don't really know if they're going to have to shift again, really. También con los proveedores de salud y salud mental. Están abriendo y diciendo, ven, ven, ven a vernos si podemos trabajar en tu salud. Pero de veras, si esta pandemia sigue, van a tener que cambiar cartas a servir la gente que son más enfermos. So we always have to be aware, well, how can healthcare work? And they're looking at healthcare systems. How are we going to change them? Because they lost a lot of providers in all of them. And how can we serve, how can we keep serving everybody while saving the lives of those who are. And that's why they were saying, you know, I know I'm really hounding on this today, but the vaccine will reduce the number of people that are in the ICU. La gente que tiene la vacuna se baja la probabilidad que van a enfermarse con la pandemia. Entonces, los hospitales tienen que estar preparados porque si la gente que no tiene la vacuna pueden también enfermarse. Tienen que estar preparados para servir.
So I have a question for you, Dr. Rivera. I work with many in my consulting work in the state with small businesses. As you all know, as I mentioned before, this idea of new standards, policies, and procedure. Can you give an example of that? Españoles, como le digo a la doctora, trabajando yo con muchos emprendedores en el estado, y veo también que hay necesidad para tener una forma de reglas, ¿no? Dicen estándares, políticas y procedimientos. Entonces, como nadie le gusta cambio, no one likes change, really. I mean, there's
unless
a little
bit. Idea.
Right. We all always love our ideas, right? But we tend to be resistant at times to those that come outside. But I guess what I'm getting at here, lo que quería llegar es a preguntarle a la doctora, what I want to ask the doctor is then what may be a way that we can think in a positive way about change? ¿Cómo podemos pensar de cambio en algo positivo, no? Para ayudar a nuestro negocio sobre.
Sí. Pues eso es una pregunta. Una cosa es que juntos, casi siempre el dueño decide en lo que va a hacer y lo hace y hace las decisiones y luego dice a los empleados, ahora tienes que hacer esto, eso y lo. Pero sale un poquito mejor, toma más tiempo. Y más trabajo, y es más trabajo, pero sale mejor si puedes preguntar a los empleados, ahora como vamos a abrir de nuevo o ofrecer otras cosas, ¿qué son las ideas que ustedes tienen para asegurar que la gente sigue con las políticas, tenemos los procedimientos para seguir y proteger a este negocio? ¿Cuáles son sus ideas? Cuando los empleados o los miembros de una familia tienen la voz que ha sido, que han comunicado bien las ideas. Es un ejemplo de respeto. Y también la gente quiere hacer los ideas suyas. So you ask people, what ideas do you have? Because we have to keep these standards and policies and procedures. And we've all been through this and we have to continue. What do you think would well better? What are your ideas? And do the and institute the ones that you can do. It's a sign of respect, and you will always get better compliance with workers and with children and spouses if they're included. Okay, because one of the things in families is the parents may say, well, I'm the parent, you do what I tell you. That doesn't fly as well anymore. And so it's really more respectful. You also have people understand this business depends on you, and I need you to help solve problems too.
Good. That's
okay.
Like that.
So that's the other thing to teach. And you support the employee and client morale. In other words, I feel good because this is hard, but he asked and or she asked and we're doing this differently now. Okay, or I'm gonna work towards an award for being the best, you know. For example, in grocery stores where you can pick up your groceries. Hey, it's hard work, man. There's somebody in there shopping for your groceries, they're running around the store. That's very hard work. And a lot of times they don't even get tipped. Okay. So preguntando, pidiendo la opinión de los clientes, también con los empleados, puedes, ellos van a estar más de acuerdo con usted y las decisiones si incluyes las ideas de ellos también. Okay. Ellos van a ser.
Pretty straightforward. Okay. Be willing to ask other people for input, right?
Exactly.
Pregúnteles dos palabras, respeto, y quiero la idea aquí es tenerle respeto a la gente.
Cooperación.
Y cooperación con otros. Es algo que nos ayuda en la vida y en el negocio.
It's a really different idea. Okay.
For many.
Yeah. Okay, next slide. So, en el futuro, si los números se suben otra vez, vamos a tener las cuarentenas. Mm-hmm. Así es la vida. Es la regla de vida. ¿Alguna gente quiere seguir trabajando de la casa? Es una opción en algunos negocios, no es opción en otros. Y algunos negocios están teniendo problemas porque la gente no quiere regresar a trabajar. Pero tienen que hacerlo. Pero ¿cómo puedes tener la gente trabajando de la casa pero seguir avanzando el negocio si no están? Entonces están cambiando los horarios, cambiando las computadoras y todo eso. A ver, ¿cómo van a balancear trabajando de la casa, trabajando en la oficina? So a lot of businesses are struggling right now because a lot of people don't want to go back to work on site. They want to stay home. So for those businesses that permit it, they have to figure out, well, how we're going to balance this work there. Because it's a balance where the boss or the owner wants to give people and respect their opinion and their desires, but it can't always be that. You still have to run. And the same with homeschooling. That's going to be a whole nother scene when the community gets together and talks to their school system and says, this is what we need, this is what we expect. Because last year we saw the open, close, in a lot of districts. It was not statewide. Some districts in the state closed and that was it. It was just homeschooling. Other systems were kind of up and down with it. So they will be discussing that and learn how they're going to do it.
Boy, that's a hard one. Homeschooling, es difícil, ¿no? Enseñar de la casa. Basically, you're trying to run your business, and that's hard for any entrepreneur because it's a 24/7 type work. For many entrepreneurs, that's just the way it is to be successful. So how now you homeschool, that's definitely a stress.
Right.
Right, es estresor también lo que digo, si ya tienes un negocio donde te dedicas 24 horas al día, casi muchos negocios, no digo que todos son igual, pero y luego aparte de eso te enseñaron los, como se dice en la frontera, los bookies,
yeah,
los chiquitos,
los
¿no?
chiquitos,
¿Cómo le vamos a hacer todo,
sí.
Valencia? Tiene que ser difícil, stressors, right?
Y ahorita,
these are all hard.
Y ahorita dicen, pero ahorita el gobierno dio más dinero para el cuidado de los niños. There has been additional money for childcare. So more people can now receive childcare. It's based on your income. Ahorita, más gente puede recibir dinero o el gobierno pagará por el cuidado de los niños ahora porque califica. Okay, han cambiado el
that
nivel.
Changed over the weekend,
okay.
Right?
That changed last week.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Pero la cosa es que aunque el gobierno ha dicho ahora este es el nivel más alto y más gente puede calificar, los guarderías y los centros de los niños no están preparados. Entonces, eso sí es difícil, porque esos sistemas requieren que los maestros están, que tienen el entrenamiento.
Ah, buena idea.
Y perdieron muchos trabajadores durante la pandemia porque se cerraron a los centros. Ahora, hasta ahora están abiertos, pero no hay los trabajadores antes que estaban como, saben cómo hacerlo, no están certificados.
Una oportunidad, doctora, para just an opportunity, I was saying in Spanish, for those of you who have not visited an SBDC office, here's your opportunity. Go and learn about what resources they have for starting a child care center, maybe, because in the horizon, it looks like there's going to be more folks qualifying for child care.
Much more.
And there aren't enough child care centers out
yeah.
there. En español, lo más quiero decir muy pronto, ¿no? Que, como menciona la doctora, es que enseñando de la casa es difícil, pero lo que hay que notar es que si tiene usted una oficina del SBDC cerca donde está usted en su ciudad, hay que ir y preguntarles si tienen información acerca de abrir un centro de cuidar niños, porque va a haber mucha necesidad.
¿Cómo no? Y toda los cuidados de los niños no tienen que pasar en un centro. Puede ser proveedor o proveedora de cuidado de los niños de tu casa. Okay, you can be a home child care provider as well. I mean, there's a lot of regulations, but it's something that can be done, you know. Porque el cuidado de los niños es un apoyo del trabajo. Si no hay nadie para cuidar a los niños, la gente no puede trabajar.
Sí, yes.
Entonces, por eso están dando más apoyo con más oportunidad de cuidado de los niños. Pero eso es un... podemos discutirlo mucho tiempo, pero
sí,
eso es otro cambio.
Nada más para decirle a los que están oyendo, ¿no? Para eso existen los SBDCs, los que vayan a hablar con ellos.
Y también en la oficina del Estado,
right.
Del Early Childhood.
Right.
Okay. No solamente es el CYFD jamás, sino hay un departamento nuevo de Early Childhood.
Okay.
Y así está ahí está localizado el cuidado de los niños.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, let's go ahead to the next slide. Okay, so we talk about working from home, working at work, new routines, and money issues. Pues ya dice la gente, y es la verdad, que toma 6 semanas para establecer un hábito nuevo. Un hábito positivo. Puede ser negativo, pero ojalá que positivo. Entonces la pandemia se pasó por 1 año y medio. O sea, si estabas trabajando con nuevas rutinas que todos están trabajando todos, o si estabas cuidando y cooperando con el dinero y el flujo de efectivo, entonces puedes seguir, okay? One of the things is that you made the change during the pandemic to establish new routines. If they work better, keep them.
Mm-hmm.
If you discussed and were able to watch the spending of money and find places to improve your cash flow and increase it, keep that. So some things resulted that were very good with the pandemic because people were forced to solve those problems. Si algo trabaja bien, quédatelo con ellos y sigue con ellos en el futuro. Vamos a tener otros cambios. Y para tener éxito con el cambio, tenemos que estar preparados. 80% del éxito en la vida viene de ser prevenido. O preparados. Okay. Tenemos que prepararnos para tener éxito. Pero mucho del éxito depende en preparación.
Mm-hmm.
So 80% of success is really attributed to, is because of preparation. So we can continue to do what works that we learned in the pandemic. Keep that. That's a good idea. We learned that. It was hard to learn it, but people figured it out. And then prepare for whatever next change comes. Okay, next slide. So el aislamiento, ansiedad, depresión, esos fueron los problemas, los problemas con pensamientos y sentimientos, y siguen, eso sí sigue. Y la gente, por ejemplo, cuando sales a ver a la gente afuera en los negocios, son muy ansiosos, son muy más agresivos, mucho más agresivos. Por eso, we've seen isolation, the depression, the anxiety. People have gotten much more, I'll say that in terms of driving depression, see that in more larger community. So that's one of the things that we want. Next slide. Preocupación y culpa, worry and guilt. Esos son modos de tratar de cambiar lo que ha pasado. En el futuro es la culpa. No, en el futuro es la preocupación. En el pasado es la culpa. So we really can't change what has happened. So instead of worrying, we need to prepare. We saw a lot of disturbed sleep. One of the things is people have been affected, who have actually had COVID, have had their sleep patterns disturbed. That's true. Many people have had disturbed apathy. One of the symptoms of COVID was loss of the sense of taste, smell. But for most people, they are able to get back into good sleep and okay eating patterns if they follow a routine.
Mm-hmm. Good point. Routine is important.
Routine is muy important. Yeah, muy important. Okay, let's go on to it. So, entonces, preparación otra vez, ¿no? Con comunicación, pidiendo la opinión de otros. Estando abierto a las opiniones y los sentimientos de otros y compartiéndolos con de nuestros sentimientos también, manteniendo control, pero a la misma vez compartiendo. ¿Sí? La gente puede ser, pues, si es difícil para ellos también. Y construyendo procesos y los resultados más allá de sus okay. Entonces, tienes que hacer el negocio mejor, no solamente por los ingresos, sino el producto, el progreso, el proceso, el bienestar.
Oye, doctora, ¿qué es tolerar la vulnerability? ¿Qué quiere decir eso? Porque yo soy gente de negocio y me voy a proteger. If I'm in a business, I don't want to be necessarily vulnerable.
Sí, pues,
so what are we saying?
Pues siendo vulnerable quiere decir que hay posibilidad que te puedes lastimar en el negocio, en las opciones, etc.
Okay.
Entonces la gente se protege, especialmente en el negocio, siendo yo soy el dueño, así será y no voy a cambiar nada. pero demostrando a, mostrando a la gente que puedes cambiar. Y es difícil para usted también, pero aunque es difícil, vas a hacer la cosa buena, siguiendo la ley. Puedes enseñar a la gente que sí te afecta, pero vas a hacer.
Okay,
so that you can show that things have been hard for you too, but you're still going to do it anyway. Okay, so you adopt, adjust, and revise. Tienes que adaptar, ajustar y revisar. A ver qué trabaja bien, qué tienes que hacer antes para. And I think that's our ideas for today.
Perfecto.
Gracias, señor doctor Lozano.
Adjust, adopt, and what was the third one? Let me go back.
Adjust and revise.
And revise, which I think is important for everyone to remember. I want to update everyone on what's coming up. We have an evening session with Dr. Lozano at 6:30 p.m. So if you need some extra time to get into the webinar, we have that coming up. We also have coming up, let me just tell you some of the stuff we have. We have basic steps to starting a business. That will be in, we'll start in just a little bit. We also have Cash is King, learning about cash management. That's coming up this week. We also have the most important web stat for your small business. So I want to invite everyone to come out and take advantage of these webinars. Sorry about that phone.
It's okay.
So we do want to invite everyone to come out. Make sure that you take advantage of these no-cost webinars. So thanks to Dr. Lozano and thanks to Dr. Rivera. We really appreciate it. And you guys have a great rest of your day.
Thank you, Leslie.
You're welcome. Okay, let me stop the recording.